Yo, 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 it's Big Ed, man. We back. Another edition of Urban Politicians TV. Had to come tap in one time with Janae, man. Okay. One Life Clothing. She out here doing her thing, pumping her brand. One thing about me, if I see somebody working and I like the product and what they selling, I try to tap in with them. You know, especially if it's some low, like we in the same region, we same stomping grinds. I'm like, hey. Because there's people who want to tap in, but it might be 45 minutes away.
Yeah.
Hour away. I'm like, damn, I get to them.
Yes, sir.
But if you right here in my backyard, we right in the same backyard, I try to tap in quickly.
We in the point, man.
And I already been fucking with the team already, so it makes sense, man. So introduce yourself. Now, she does. Now, this is, I want to say, this is the first clothing line brand owner that I had on here. Now, I've had rappers who've had their merch. You feel me? I've had rappers who had merch. Shout out to my boy Road Runners Worldwide, you know what I'm saying? My boy Baby World out of Detroit, he got merch. I've talked to several artists who got merch, but as far as you coming in, it's strictly a fashion, you know, owner and having your own brand. I want to say, don't hold me to it. I want to say you the first one, though.
Okay,
I've done a lot of interviews. We're going to say you the first one.
We're going to roll with that one. What's
so introduce yourself. Tell them where you're from and everything like that.
All right. Well, I go by Janae Inspire. Yeah. I'm from right here, Greens Point, 56, Northside, Houston, Texas.
Sure.
Born and raised. We out here. We just trying to get out here, get these clothes out here, get this music out here. We just trying to push the culture.
Okay. Mm-hmm. For sure. So, you grew up heavy in the fashion through music, or was it just like all around? Like what really got you rocking with the fashion? Cause you know, I look through your IG, I see you got the kind of vintage drip.
You on
all the Jordan 1s, like you a little bit more elevated than what our area kind of perceives to have. You know what I'm saying? Because if you're coming from this area, you know, this is a white tee. You know, shit slimmed down now. Everybody wears slimmer clothes, but this is most definitely one of them eras where one of them areas where niggas go to the corner store, get the big ass white tee, big black tee, Air Force Ones, Jordans, or niggas hitting Greens Point Mall getting Giorgio fits.
Shopping that fit.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Hey, I'm gonna be real with niggas though. Hey,
believe it,
I'm still going to Greens Point Mall. I don't give
all
a fuck.
All my shoes, my hats, everything.
Hey, even, hey, I go in there. Hey, I'm gonna be all the way real with niggas. They can say what they want about me, nigga. I'm still hitting Greens Point Mall. That bitch right down the street. They got pants in there that fit how I like how the motherfuckers fit.
Mm-hmm.
They got t-shirts that like how I fit. I don't give a damn. I ain't got time to be driving to the Galleria.
Hey.
You know what I'm saying? It's the drip is in you, not on you. I'm like Boosie. That nigga say, I'm a $20 shirt, me a motherfucking bitch to death.
Okay.
I'm that nigga. I'm gonna get one for 10 if that
don't
bitch rock it. I go to Foot,
pool.
Hey, I just went to Foot Action, bucked me a badass $10 motherfucker last week or something
they
like
got all
that.
The sales.
Yeah, so we fucking with Greens Point still, but
yes,
I painted that picture to let niggas know this is, if you got a hood area in your city where the niggas kind of seen as country and soulful, or this is one of them areas.
Yeah,
but
it's one of them.
With the internet, everything else, some people elevated early into the fashion.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Over here.
Mm-hmm.
I think I was kind of one of the ones. I never hopped on a designer wave, really, but I was early on Nike SBs. I was wearing them 10 years ago.
That's that old 605.
Yeah, all the old Air Max, the retro Air Max special edition Dunks.
Yeah.
I was on all that. So when I see you, I say, okay, you was part of that wave. Had to be.
Yeah.
Okay.
That was me. I was one of them. Well, the way I got into fashion, I could probably say, all right, give this to my grandparents. My grandmother, my grandfather, like those are the first people I seen. It was just like every day.
Yeah.
They have to be dripping some kind of way. Like he got to make sure he starts charging his Dickies. His dress shirt got to be pressed. He had to have the right hat. She had to make sure Sundays was her day. That was her day. She's finna step out. You know what I mean? Then came down to my mama. My mama's like that. Like, she's a killer.
Yeah.
And then I guess it just came down to me.
Like, okay. So it was like just seeing them put together every day made you want to get put together every day.
Yes.
Okay. That's
that
what's
exactly
up.
What it is.
So that's what's up. So were they supportive in your fashion style and you going at the fashion? They was the kind of parents like, hey, My daughter want them new shoes. We gonna try to make them happy for her. Or were they like, what was they on? Was they on like, man, you don't need new shoes or that?
Okay, so my mom was in between.
Okay.
MJ's that I would want.
Yeah.
And she wouldn't get them because it's too much or whatever. But if we go like, I don't know if you remember Wieners, they used to be over there.
Okay.
Where that meat market at?
I know what you're talking about.
We go to Wieners. And they used to have the J's on there, and I could get like them old school team J's or whatever. She was like, right, you can get those. And then every now and again, I get the regular J's, and my daddy will give them for me, or my big brother, you know, something like that. But other than that, she was a little more, you don't need that type shit, but she ended up
Honestly, I remember that Wieners, boy, you took a nigga back. I remember they had them Gary Payton's in that motherfucker one time.
Okay.
I had got the hoes up out of Niggas don't know about that, how them Jordans and all them kicks used to be at Wieners and shit for the low. Niggas don't remember when Jordans used to be like just sitting on the shelves and shit, man. I remember that shit. They used to sit there and they used to be in these department stores and shit like that. That shit crazy, because you won't find that shit now at all. But so eventually, who would you say, was it somebody in the rap game that kind of inspired you to get into fashion more as far as the business side, or was it like, I just want to have my own creativity?
Man, the way I actually got into it, I got to shout out my boys, shout out CJ Rogers and CJ Ridley.
Okay.
Rogers, I was at Stephen F. Austin State University, that's in Nacogdoches. I was up there, he seen me on campus. We stayed in the same dorm. He's like, man, she fly, da 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 da. And I was just like, okay, every time he seen me, he like, hey, what's up? Hey, you fly, da da. I'm like, oh, appreciate it. He was coming up with an idea with his friends on One Life Clothing. He's just like, man, we just need an extra, like something to push it over.
Okay.
So he had came to me on the yard one day and was like, hey, like, we got this One Life Clothing thing going on. Like, you fly, you dope, you want to be a part of it. I was just like, shit, I guess so. I never thought about having my own shit. Like, I just like wearing shit, you know what I'm saying? So I was just like, all right, cool.
Yeah.
So from there, that was like 2013 all the way to now. Like, here we are.
For sure, for sure. So that's been around for a minute then.
Yeah.
That's what's up. That's what's up. So what would you say was the hardest part of getting it started? So are they still part of the team now, or is it?
Just Rogers and Ridley.
Yeah, okay, y'all both still on? Mm-hmm. Okay, y'all still with it. So what would you say is the hardest part about getting it started? Because we've seen a lot of people start up brands and start up like clothing lines. I remember it was a wave.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody that got their mama had a clothing line for like 2 months, and then they stopped selling. But you've been around with it for, what, that 6 years now?
Yeah, it's a good six. Like, I would probably say we were active 2014, so five. Yeah.
Okay, about 5 years. What would you say would be the hardest part with getting this brand going and keeping it and staying afloat?
For one, you got to make sure you really want to do it. Okay. Make sure it's something you can keep up with. Finances got to be in order. Everybody got to be on one accord mentally.
True.
Like, you can't be on you up here and they're back there mentally, then it ain't gonna work. And that's how a lot of people end up dropping off and end up being just us three.
Gotcha.
But yeah, that's basically how they went. Like, we stopped, we started. Like, it's a lot of ups and downs, but I was like, you know what, like, I gotta keep going. And to be honest, this was the first year that I just picked it back up.
Okay.
And I gotta thank my cousin, you know, KIE Bat, shout outs to him, you know what I'm saying? Like, he kinda pushed a little, you know, fire behind me, cause he was just like, hey man, I got this press, man, we can do it now. I'm like, you know what? Like, you right down the street from me, like, what's stopping me now?
For sure.
So we start kicking it back on, so shout outs to him.
For sure, for sure. So One Life Clothing, man, y'all got it popping, y'all got it going. Tell them the website where they can shop and get it at. And everything. And we finna show them some, but go and get the website.
Yeah. All right, so y'all can check us out at 1NELIFE clothing.bigcartel.com. Go ahead and click on there. It's gonna have some you want. Just go and scroll through there.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? A little small, little.
Yeah.
We're gonna
show them that. So,
you know what I'm saying?
I wanna talk about too. Give them your other Instagram, your personal Instagram. They get in touch with you on there also. Give them
Okay. Well, my personal Instagram is at Janae_inspire, JANAE_INSPIRE.
Sure.
And, you know, hit me up there. Hit up Instagram for One Life Clothing. It's just at One Life Clothing.
So this is actually the clothing line right here, and it says beware of the snakes in the grass. So it's the dare theme, right?
Yes, sir.
And but now I rock with it because it stood out to me, and I really like the other one better, the one that say frenemies.
Yeah.
The yellow one, that's cool. Y'all go down the Instagram page on a blog and y'all will see that one too. But it's beware of the snakes in the grass. I actually just copped one of these, and I'm gonna see if I can buy this hat too, because I really rock with it, you know what I'm saying? But the thing that I really do like about this right here, the snakes in the grass, that's a big concept. And I think that reaches out to everybody in the world, and not even just, you know, friends, just everywhere.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? That's something that's really applying to life. You know, you get on Instagram right now, everybody talking about somebody crossing them and somebody doing them dirty. You actually wearing one right now.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Beware of the snakes in the grass, man. It's a real dope.
Out there.
Yeah, the message is out there. It's dope. anybody can relate to it. Yes, so what really inspired that meaning for you?
Oh man, I think what was going on, it was a lot of shady shit going on. Not exactly to me,
okay,
but just around me. And then one day, of course, you know, I was kind of on my level. Yeah. And that's usually how my designs end up coming out.
Okay.
But I was sitting there thinking, I was just like, man, these snakes, bro.
Yeah.
And I already had a friend of me going. So I was right. just like, you know, how can I incorporate something? I was just like, snakes in the grass. Where? Dare. And I was like, I was one of them kids. You know, I grew up with the dare shirts, you know, say that was my shit.
Yeah.
So I was like, all right, let's go ahead and incorporate, do a little switch and just put beware of the snakes in the grass. People will fuck with it because, I mean, a lot of people in my era, that was our shit. You know what I'm saying? So I was just a blast from the past, but a message.
Bad, for sure. Now, I will say this, though. I've seen other people try to, like, you know, go get the vintage dare shirts and wear them, and they did what they did and everything. I've seen people pull out the jackets.
Yeah.
But y'all's is crazy because it looks like the dare shit, but it's way harder.
Yeah,
this shit is just way harder.
I appreciate it.
How you play it, too, because, like, I can really see a nigga, like, with this style hat, I fuck with these type of hats. I got some made myself for Urban Politicians before.
Yeah.
I ain't really been wearing them and shit like that, but I do got some.
Yeah.
But to see, like, okay, you got this wave, you got this drip, and then the way you wear it, I can see somebody like Chris Brown wearing your shit.
Oh, man, that's little.
I can see you. No, for real. because you be playing, because, you know, we all know right now one of the staples for, like, the hipsters and the fashionable people is Jordan 1s.
Yeah.
So, and I see you play the Jordan 1s a lot. You know, they can't see right now, you got the Chicago 1s on.
Yeah.
I see you play a lot of different Jordan 1s with different drips and styles.
Mm-hmm.
So I look at that like, hey, I can see a Chris Brown coming down with one of these on. You know, he rock with the red side and all that too.
Mm-hmm, yeah.
And so I really respect it and I like it because it's dope. You know what I'm saying? So I'm looking forward to wearing my shit and pulling my shit out for sure.
Yeah.
And what would you say, what artist or what person in the game you think, hey, if I could put this on anybody, I'll put this on them?
Man, funny thing is, if I could just get it on all my local niggas. Like,
okay.
I want to get it on the people that I mess with, like, because I just know everybody that I mess with locally right now, they're going to be something.
For sure.
They're going to be something in the next 2 years.
For sure. Because I see all the hipster, the real, because, you know, a lot of niggas trying to act like they shoe niggas now.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Oh,
I'm not really, I don't like calling myself no sneakerhead because I'm not that deep into it. I don't follow all them fucking rules them niggas got.
Mm-hmm.
I don't even think niggas even call themselves sneakerheads no more. I think that wave is gone. I remember it was a point in time when niggas would be mad when you called yourself a sneakerhead, but those original tennis shoe style rappers like your Wale, I can see Wale in this. I can see Currency in this.
Oh man,
I can see
Currency in that.
Yeah, I can see a Jim Jones. Jim Jones. I can see a Jim Jones rocking, especially this red one.
Oh, yeah,
you know what I'm saying?
So, OG.
I feel like you keep pumping, you keep working.
Yeah.
People gonna tap in with you.
Man, I'm trying.
For sure, for sure.
I'm trying.
Tell them where to get at you again. They can tap in for the clothing line and everything.
Man, tap in onelifeclothing.bigcartel.com at onelifeclothing on Twitter, Instagram, all that. Y'all want to hit up me, you want to talk to me directly at Janae_inspire, JANAE_INSPIRE.
Bet. We tapped in. We locked in, man. Y'all subscribe to the channel.